Hi everyone, and thanks for joining us for another Indigo Blue Hour on the British Craft Network. I'm joined again by the lovely
Lydia Tarry.
And Lydia, you're going to be doing something fantastic today because I've already seen what we're going to be doing.
We're going to make a clock.
A Christmas time clock. Yes. Ooh, it's fantastic. So, shall we get on and do it?
Shall we?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, so we're making this fantastic clock today.
It's a snow globe in its own right. It's got shakies in it.
Oh, excellent stuff. I'd never noticed that.
Yeah,
so it looks like it's quite involved. So what are the main products in this one then?
Right, we've got our modelling paste. We've got the coarse one.
Okay, there's a fine one and a coarse one, yeah?
Yes, there is. Yeah. So that gives us that nice snowy texture look to the outside of it. Mm-hmm. We're going to use the snow globe, which is my well-loved one.
Yeah. Definitely well-loved.
Yes, absolutely. and we're going to use a brand new, you can't see it very well on there, we're going to use a brand new stencil.
Okay, this is the Roman numeral stencil.
Yes.
Yeah.
We're going to use Design Merry Christmas.
Excellent. So one of our favourite Christmas stamps. And these are all the deeply etched red rubber stamps.
They are, yes.
We're not using any photopolymer ones today.
No.
Excellent. So what about paints?
Paints we're going to use, we're going to use gesso.
Yeah, white gesso.
And we're going to use Grandma's Teacup.
Excellent.
Which is a lovely blue.
Yeah, one of our favourites.
And we're going to use Snow White, which is the metallic white.
The metallic white.
Yes.
Okay.
Okay, and obviously our flitter glue will appear in there as well. Somewhere.
Excellent stuff. So shall we get ready?
We will. Okay, so we're going to start with a really inexpensive plastic clock from a local supermarket.
Okay.
You don't need anything posh because we're going to totally change it.
We're altering it, yes.
Alter it, yes.
I love altered art. It's great.
So we're going to take all of the pieces and we need to remove the glass and the hands and the mechanism.
Right.
Okay. So, and then we'll be ready to.
So that's what we need to do first.
We do,
yes. We totally need to dismantle it.
We do.
Deconstruct.
Which is easy enough, as I say. They, you know, most of these have just got the little bits that pop out the glass, and these are all just
They're not normally all screwed together, are they?
No, no. In fact, this one's just got little
release tabs.
Yeah, which you just push with a pair of pliers or something.
Okay. So we'll do that, and then be right back.
Okay. So here we've got our pieces. We can just put those to a side for a moment. This one we're going to need in a minute.
Is that stuck down?
This is stuck down and it's right. Actually like a plastic. So
oh, right.
I've left it on. So what I'm going to do is gesso over it.
Right.
It doesn't need to be totally white because we are going to obviously put cardstock in for the top. But
right.
What you don't want is a huge, great amount of black shining through.
Okie dokes.
So, so what we'll do first, because you need to gesso this totally.
Yeah.
And, you know, all of it. And
including the outside.
Yeah, I'm going to gesso it because we're going to put modelling paste onto here.
Right.
So we want it to be able to stick to something.
Fantastic.
All right. So with our white gesso, it is literally case of slap it straight over the top. Now, I would do the centre first because I've actually done a couple of coats on this, because like I say, you're going to cover it anyway, but we just need to dull those black numbers down
right
just a touch, just to ensure that they don't sneak through later.
So you're going to cover this with a piece of card anyway, obviously.
Yes, yeah, we're
going
to
do the background. But you don't want them showing through.
No, just in case. I mean, it shouldn't do anyway, because I'm using our indigo blue white card stock, which is 350 GSM.
Right.
So
it's never, you know.
It's, but you know, and plus it's going to be hung up. So
better safe than sorry.
Yeah. Okay, so we're just going to. I mean, it hasn't got to be anything delicately done. You are literally just coating so that.
Just the one coat again, or
I mean, as I say, I might. You know, you can always go back and go over the numbers, purely because, like I say, you just don't want those to come through.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
And gessoing the outside plastic is just going to give the modelling paste something to grip onto.
Yeah, it's what we call an attached bit of teeth. And you will find that because this is a really shiny plastic, some of it may separate, but it, you know, just go over and just waft it gently with you. little heat gun.
But if you wanted to make doubly sure, you could go over it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Yeah, you know, you would know by looking at it whether or not it's and you see, even by just drying it, some of those numbers are popping back into to view.
Yeah.
If you've got the same kind of clock as this, try not to heat that centre panel too much, because it's plastic on this one.
Oh, right.
And it'll bubble. And again, I mean, we're going to cover it, but you don't want huge grate.
Yeah. And it doesn't take too long to heat set it anyway, does it? But again, you could always just paint and again, it and then go make yourself a drink.
Yes.
And by the time you come back, it's probably done.
Totally encouraged. So, yeah.
If he says, picking his coffee cup up.
So, as I say, you know, if you've got a couple of little patches that have, you know, kind of separated a bit because of the sheen on the on the plastic, you can just go back.
It's like everything else. You just keep on going until you're happy with it.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. I mean, yeah, don't want to bore you all with coats and coats of...
We can always, we can always speed through or cut you out, Lydia, don't we?
Yeah, I think so. I talk on fast forward anyway, so I suppose it doesn't make any odds. Okay, and then, as I say, I can see from that's covered, so. And it hasn't got to be too glamorous in there, as I say, because we're going to cover it. So, what we're going to do with that next is the texture paste.
Okay.
Now the texture paste, if you used it through, as we're going to do later on with the stencil, doesn't take very long at all to dry.
Right.
It's really quite fast in drying because you're not using a great thickness. To cover this, we're obviously, you know, it's going to be thicker layers.
Right. I can see some of that is still wet it's on the side. Still, is that okay? Or do we need to just leave it for a bit and then come back when it's dry?
You were better off with it drying, to be honest. But having said that...
Okay, let's... For the viewers, it'll be instantaneous. But for us, let's just take a break there and let that dry.
We'll just leave it to dry.
We'll be right back.
Okay. So our gesso's dry. We're going to now... add the modelling paste.
Okay. This is the stinky modelling paste.
Yeah.
It's not too bad.
No.
Just don't let the cat go near it.
So, yeah, well, this is the coarse one. So, as I say, it's a bit like doing royal icing on cakes.
Yeah.
You can just, you know. So, to start with, you just need to smooth. It's not got to be anything.
We were trying to work out what the gritty pieces are inside it. We couldn't kind of work it out.
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
You can get sort of like white sand and things like that.
You can also get ones with beads in as well. Yeah. Just clear beads. But this modelling paste stays white, doesn't it?
Yes,
it doesn't go clear.
No. This one's... So as I say, you don't need a huge great, you know, layers and layers of it, because actually that's really quite a thin layer. But what you do need is it thick enough so that you can just, with the backing spatula, just...
Go and pick it up to make peaks,
because it's ideal for you know, snowy effects. Mm-hmm.
So do you make cakes as well?
I used to.
I could tell with a practiced hand.
Yeah, I used to. Don't get time now. I'll leave that to the kids. But that's as technical as that as that gets, to be honest. Now, what the bit that you do need to be careful, obviously all clocks are going to be slightly different.
Yeah.
But obviously we've got to put our glass front back in.
Yep.
So what you don't want to do is do the inside of here or get any bits that overlap, because you'll be surprised how tight the glasses fit into the
glass. Yeah, I can imagine.
And if you've got bits that are sticking out, you won't get the glass back in without having to sand it possibly or... something. So although you don't have to be too careful to start with, just run your finger back around it to ensure that you've not got, and as I say, there's no great technique to this. It's a case of I'm being a bit selfish on time taking it.
She's clutching it to her chest.
Okay, so we're just going to carry on going all the way around the edge of this. And because when you use this normally with a stencil or something similar, or just, you know, if you're just sort of randomly spreading some around, you're not going to have a very thick layer, so therefore it doesn't take very long to dry at all. But because you have got a depth to this, I would suggest you leave it overnight.
Right.
Because if you do pick it up and it is still slightly wet, you'll end up with it sliding and you get bald patches although you can kind of, it doesn't matter too greatly.
No.
It's pretty much disguised. You just don't want to.
And you just keep going around until you're happy with it.
Absolutely.
So are you going to, I noticed on this one there was some little
gems
and things. Yeah, oh, not gems, but pearls.
They're little half pearls, but you can use, I did one before that had little tiny weeny pom-poms.
Oh, yeah.
So you can just stick those in and then glitter them afterwards or whatever you're happy with putting on there, really. You just need something just to decorate up. So if I just put that like that. I've just got some little half pearls. You can use whatever colour you like, because you can actually, with a very fine brush, change them to, with if you use our paints, you can change them to whatever colour you want, really. And it's a bit like just putting, again, with your cake
decorating
making.
Yeah,
absolutely. Okay, and it doesn't matter if you've got some snow on the top of it, because...
just makes it more real.
That's what it's all about. Okay, so you can just... some of those.
Right, so are we going to carry on do this then and then leave that to dry, or we've got one that we've prepared earlier?
I have got one that I've prepared earlier, only because sometimes you just need to, and underneath you've got somewhere to hold on to, you can hang all the way around.
But also it takes overnight to dry.
It does, so. And it's basically the same principle all the way around the edge, and then you're just going to pop your...
Take that one away from you then, and then we'll come back and I'll pass you the one that you've already prepared earlier.
Thank you.
There you go.
Thank you very much.
Ta-da, by the magic of TV.
Yes, look at that. Okay, so we've got the same look to that. That's just dried totally. And we're ready to go to the next piece. Now, as you can see, you can still see the numbers through here, but to be honest, they're dulled down and we're going to cover that with card anyway, when we're finished. So actually, we're going to set that one aside for a moment and then we're going to move on to...
We're going to get ready for the next
slide.
Okay.
All right. Okay, so the next part we need to do is the centre of the clock.
Yep.
And what we're going to do is use our... ready-made template.
Okay.
Now I'm doing mine on an A4 sheet of card, purely because if you cut the circle out before you do the background painting, it buckles.
Right.
Ask me how I know. So
I guess we must have been there before.
Yeah. So I'm just gonna draw around. Okay.
Yeah.
And then that's going to be our reverse.
Right.
All right, because we don't want the pencil lines, even with the best cutting in the world. You might get some, and it's not a great edge. So what we're going to do is turn it over. Now, it depends on what light you've got, but what you need to do is just roughly, and I only do this purely because I want to ensure that when I'm doing my painting, I actually cover that area, because I don't want to cover the whole A4 card, that's pointless. But I do want to make sure that I've got paint going round or to the edges or over the edges, so that you've got enough. Okay, that's it. So, and then we're going to put a coat of gesso on here.
Okay, so using the white gesso again.
We are, yes. And that's mainly because we're going on to cardstock.
Yeah.
And with paint, what you put down is basically going to stay.
Yeah.
We need to move it around just a little bit because we need to sort of make a snowy background look. Mm-hmm. Okay, so again, nothing glamorous. Now that you're saying, well, you've just made those pencil marks and now you're going to go over them. But it doesn't really matter, because we are going to, as long as I keep with my gesso now for the next layers, I know that I've got enough coverage.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so if I now make my background, when I do the paint to where my gesso is, I know I'm okay.
Yeah.
All right, so nothing glamorous with that. Just, I can't really see that very well, can you?
It's white on white,
see a
isn't
bit
it?
Of a shine.
There you go.
Okay. Yeah. So, next we need another one of my wonderful wax papers. Now, you can use what you like, craft mat,
just somewhere
paper,
to put your paint on.
Something, yeah. Yes. That it just means that you can throw it away afterwards.
Yeah, which is always good without having to clean.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
We're all in favour of not washing up.
No, that's right. Right, we're going to use Grandma's teacup.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is purely just for a little bit of sky.
Yeah.
It's a snowy day, so we don't need blue right, skies. So and
we're just building up a background.
But we
image.
Just need a little bit of colour going on somewhere there. So that's literally all I'm going to use. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's that one. And then. Shall I end up with texture paint?
Gritty paint, that's
yes,
all you need.
That's it. And then we're going to put Snow White,
mm-hmm.
which is the metallic.
Yeah.
All right, so because we've used such a small amount of Grandma's mm-hmm. teacup, by mixing Snow White with it, we're not going to get a totally metallic blue.
No.
But we will get a little bit of a shimmer going on.
Yeah.
All right. Make sure you're not going to carry blue into your pot. And then we need another patch with
of just a pure
Snow White.
Yeah. A pure Snow White.
Yes.
And that little splodge of water doesn't make any difference. It just blob up.
No. None at all, because we're going to actually add a little bit of water to these, because we just need it to move across the gesso.
Yeah. Yeah.
And we don't need to drown it. We just need
a little squirt.
Oh, yes.
Like me.
Yes. I'll take it off just in case.
There you go.
Okay. So, as I say, looking at where you've got your gesso,
mm-hmm.
do you see what I mean? It, that little bit of blue is still really quite
just kind of
a
makes
deep
it a bit,
colour, but yeah. it's
just
still,
makes it a bit pastely, doesn't it?
Yes. I mean, if you don't want any shimmer to that at all, you can obviously mix it with the gesso, but that gives it just that off-white. And then we're just going to swipe. Gently, because as I say, it's a snowy background. We don't mm-hmm. need to be totally blue skied.
Like a winter sky.
Yes. And that's it. We don't need to do anything else
okay.
with that one for
that
a minute.
That was quick and easy.
It was. And then with the Snow White, we're going to do the rest. And of course, you can go over as much of this as you want to. So nothing technical with this. Just...
And nothing very exact or...
She says with a...
With a texture.
Yeah. It's snow at the end of the day. Okay, but you just don't want the harsh lines of a...
A blue and a white,
no.
yeah, next to each other. So we're just blending them together.
So, yeah, and then you can always just do little squiggles. Because when that dries, you're not going to... get those quite, but you just need to, it just gets the hint of the blue coming through.
A little touch of impasto.
And then once you've got what you've got going down here, you can go back with your blue, and just by touching the end, just do little...
Almost like shadows.
Just, yeah, just like you almost get like that hilly effect going on, and that's it. That's it. There's nothing more to it than that.
Very, very subtle.
Yes. All right. And that just gives you a slight hint of blue for your sky and your snowy base with a little bit of shadow going on. All right. And then we're just going to heat set because that needs to be totally dry now before you start to stamp on it.
Excellent stuff.
And it shouldn't take too long because the gesso is dry, it's just the paint. You just need to make sure that it is dry. Okay.
Super.
Okay, so this is our dry surface and I've just trimmed off the edge just so that it gives us a little bit more of a easier size to work with. Okay, so our little shadows in the snow or down the bottom, and that needs to be relatively as you want it when you look at it. We're going to now use our snow globe, and we're going to use that for the center, which we need to do first.
Right.
Now, because you've got wording at the bottom, you need that to be, well, I'd like them to be straight.
Yeah.
I'm a bit...
As straight as you can.
Yeah. So, I've cut, using the same method, I've just drawn around the faceplate and I'm onto a piece of paper. So then you just fold it in half one way. Fold it in half the other way.
Mm-hmm.
You then find the centre, because you also need to make sure that your clock mechanism is going to go in the centre.
In the middle, yeah.
Okay, so you can use a pokey tool or something to go through the centre of there.
Yeah.
I also use my template to find the base of my and straight line for my snow globe. So if you follow your fold line to the fold line of the centre.
Yeah, that's going to give you half again.
That gives you half. Now, to do that, that then gives you enough room, because we're going to stencil the numbers at the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you know then that you've got enough space to put your stencil numeral. If you flip it back down this way, you then know that, you know, you can adjust that on that because you've got your line still. And just ensure that that is then straight with where you want it to be.
And you can use that as a guide for stamping.
Yes. So then you know, here's one I made earlier. I'm just going to swap that. It's got the tape on it. Okay. So then you can just make sure. She says. Okay. Flip that down. And then you know that you're going to get a straight edge.
So you've just used, it could be a post-it note or a bit of masking tape.
Yeah, absolutely anything. It's just the fact that you then know that you're on a straight, because there's nothing worse than having a
every little tip helps, doesn't it?
Well, it is. And I think, you know, sometimes we can sit there with the best will in the world trying to line up things.
Is that the right size block?
No, it's not. Oops. That's the appropriate. Okay, and then if you line up the bottom, and also just don't take for granted that you are lining up with the bottom of your block, because if your cut line for your stamp isn't straight either, that's going to make a difference. So just make sure that you're happy with the lining of your stamp on your block.
Yeah, another good tip.
Okay, then we're going to use, now you can use whatever, I've used this one purely because it's the colour that I wanted.
Yeah.
Archival is always a good one, because if you've got anything wet going on, then, you know, it's going to be fine. But I just wanted the colour of this one, so that's what we're going with. Okay, light tapping. And if you try and work it so that you go across, you don't fill in this blank piece. I know some people cut them out, don't they? But I like mine to stay as they are. Okay.
I think if you cut the middle out, it tends to go...
Well, you've got more lines then, haven't you? Just kind of. So I'm not giving myself even more problems. Okay, so there's your centre, all right, because you've still got that centre fold. So you roughly sort of line up your centre of your stamp along that.
Super.
Okay. So that gives us... our snow globe. I've done it right in there anyway, because it's a...
Just give it a bit of a wash.
Yeah, just... Okay.
Wash and wipe.
And then we just need to whiz over that image with our heat gun, just because...
Because we want to get on and work.
Yes. Yeah, we don't have sit around time. But because we need to then mask this off to do our buildings.
Oh, right, okay.
Okay, so there we go. Right, this can now come off. And then what we're going to do is the buildings, which are going to come out from either side. So we don't want them inside the snow globe.
No.
All right. So... you can make these in different ways, post-it notes or This is actually transfer paper. So if you it's just a sheet of sticky that you can put onto things like acrylic or transfers and things, so or even peel offs.
Oh, right. Okay.
That you can then peel it up and the peel off sticks on there. Yeah, you can then transfer it as a whole as opposed to stretching stuff. So it's that kind of thing.
Yeah.
So then you just need to place that over your, in fact, if you work it from the bottom. Okay. Doesn't have to be anything really, really stuck. And we're going to use our buildings that come with the snow globe set.
Yeah. If I just take that out of the packet. So you actually get the buildings with the snow globe and the...
And the little Christmas tree.
It isn't pink. Is it? That's another mask as well. It's a good place to store your masks, actually.
It is, because it's laminate, so it comes off. Right, now the thing with these is that they've got a straight edge, which is fine, but I don't want straight edges on my buildings on here. Okay, they're sort of like disappearing behind the shadows. So all I've got is a piece of paper, and all you need to do is tear. Right, nothing technical, because I don't do that. All right, and then when we ink it, all you're going to do is just ink it with this.
Right.
So it misses kind of the bottom. So when you put it onto here, you're not going to get such a solid edge.
You could also put that down on there and you then can. Stamp it over the top.
You
if you
can. And in fact, that might be easier for us.
Might not be as fiddly.
No, absolutely. So ink your. Now I'm using London Fog, which is just a grey.
Yeah.
So it just sort of like blends into the background. I think if you use black, it's going to be too harsh. Mm-hmm. So we're just going to go somewhere along there, and then what you need to do is ensure that you're actually somewhere along here, but also within your, because you don't want to stop your buildings too far in. Okay. Uh-huh. So your edge is coming around here, so we've got our buildings in and you've got your buildings there, and we've not got
a straight line.
Such a straight line. It looks as if they're kind of behind a snowy hill somewhere. And then we're going to do the same as the other side, but you don't need to have them dead in line.
Because towns aren't.
No, and sometimes things have to be in line and sometimes things just don't. Okay, so we're just going to do the same the other side. All right.
Marvellous.
All right. Then we can peel off our mask and then we've got our buildings.
Lovely.
All right. Let's just whiz over that because we don't want wet.
Just give it a quick blast. Shall I put your mask back on the back of your snow globe?
Yes, Star, thank you. Okay.
And then that's one for your houses too.
Wonderful. Right, okay. So the next part we need to do we're going to do our texture paste next, because we can then centre from each end and we're not getting in too much of a mess when we do our tree in the middle.
Okay, so we're doing the texture paste through the stencil.
Yes, so we're back with our texture paste, and I'm going to keep with the coarse because I think it's sort of, it matches.
Excuse
the
rattling.
Right.
Are you wanting your paper stencil again?
Yes.
Or did you want the other one?
No, my roll of tape. I might get away with this. Okay. So depending on how straight you want to be, if you put that side, okay, there's your centre.
Yeah.
So I would advise you to do your number 12 first, because otherwise if you do 6, you're going to get your arms in it. Okay, that's kind of, so that's where we need to be.
Yeah.
Now ideally you probably would want to use a bigger piece of tape, mm-hmm. but because we're just going to do this piece, and then we just need to make sure that, you know, that the whole of that number 12 is covered. So starting from the top, and it's not like you've got to be, that's it, you know, to ensure that you've got it's covered, and then lift.
Oh, look at that.
Okay, now really, if you haven't got any on the back of your stencil, mm-hmm. then you can go down and do number 6.
Right.
However, I'm a bit, I don't want to end up with splodges, so I'm just going to quickly rinse that off. Because if you've got any texture paste on the back of your stencil whatsoever, you're going to transfer it somewhere else, which you may not want in that area. So we're going to go back down again now, obviously being careful with your, in fact you can just follow it down, it's just easy enough to do, and just make sure that you get the right numeral, mm-hmm. because, and these have been made so that your 12 is with your 12, 3, 6 and 9, mm-hmm. so this is our 6, which is going to go, and obviously make sure that you're within your circle too. Line up your top of your stencil with the line that's running on your snow globe, and then you know that you're going to get a straight line, as opposed to
on a wonky one.
On a tilt. Okay, take your stencil down, and then go again with that. And if you can see parts of the card underneath, then obviously just go back over.
Just give it another waft.
Yeah. Okay, just hold on to that and up and unhinge.
Okay, so what you could all do right there, if you wanted to, you could actually leave that overnight, couldn't you?
Yes.
And then come back to it the next day to put your 3 and your 9 on.
Yes. I mean, I've not got 3s and 9s on mine. I've got, if you get the matching half pearls on the ones that you've got on your clock, mm-hmm. And put them in, because otherwise you end up going over the building.
Of course,
which is fine if you want to do that. But otherwise, it just puts a...
Oh, yeah. You've just got the 12 and the 6.
Yeah. All right. And then that's your paste. Now, what I've done with mine, and again, it's personal choice whether you want to leave that to dry. You could dry it and then put the stencil back over. You could flitter glue and flake it.
Yeah.
But I'm just going to literally...
You know, drop some glitter on.
A little bit of glitter, and it hasn't got to cover it all because it just hasn't. But it just, you know, it's Christmas. We need glitter. And that's that.
So, just a little bit of glitter.
Yes, because otherwise you end up, and I know that's sticking everywhere, but that's because it's just because we didn't anti-static it, because it's a bit difficult.
But once it's dry, you can just brush that off.
Yeah,
anyway.
Absolutely. Just get one of the dry brush and just brush it off.
Okay, so we're now ready for the next step?
We are. We just need to allow that to dry.
Okay, now we'll be back in a few minutes then.
Right, so there we are. We've got our texture paste and our glitter, and we've just taken the excess glitter off.
So it's dried a bit.
Yes, and there you go. Look, you see you've got no glitter stuck anywhere apart from where you want it.
Excellent stuff. So what's next then?
Right, before we go any further, I'm just going to line this back up, mm-hmm. now that our texture paste is dry.
Yeah.
Around the edge here so that we can find the centre of our clock, because we just need to know roughly where we're. And I just use the back of that because
you're popping the hole in now.
Yeah, so there's my fold line this way, just so that I know where I'm going. Okay, now we're going to do the Christmas tree in the middle, mm-hmm. With flitter glue, because our flitter glue also does glitter, flake, anything we want to stick to it really. Okay, so we're gonna
There's your Christmas tree stamp.
So, to load off, literally add about a teaspoonful to the pack foam. And then we're going to squidge. Technical term.
Yep. So, we're going to push the glue into the foam. Which then creates a glue pad.
It does. Which which works exactly the same way as you would with an ink pad, but very much stickier.
Okie dokie.
So depending on what area you're doing, and if you're obviously doing, we've only got a little tree, but you still need to try and make sure you cover your edges.
Mm.
All right, and then I'm going to place that down on the tile so that the air doesn't get to it, and it will last me a fair few hours. Right, we're in Christmas tree, and we're going to pop it onto one of our Slim Jims. Okay. Use our flitter glue like we do an ink pad. Just make sure it's covered. And down and off.
Yeah,
you
can see
just
that.
About see yeah. on there. All right.
So unlike doing the glue onto a non-porous surface, we don't have to leave this to sit for a minute or two, do we? Or is it best to do
yeah,
that?
You still need to really, you do need to get your stamp into water because otherwise the glue will stay on there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you still need to dry this and leave it to cure a bit because otherwise you'll get, you know, it will stick. I mean, it's not so bad with glitter.
Right.
Because you don't need to scooch it off quite so much. What I'm going to do is just put glitter over the top.
Uh-huh.
Press it as opposed to rubbing it. So I'm just going to press it to make sure that it's it covers. And then because you've not got a wet surface.
Okay.
Whereas with the flake, sometimes the glue can seep through mm-hmm. the flake. So, all right. And then you
yep.
can just make sure that's covered. And then I
just push down.
Press down, yeah. Only just to, because you just don't want to end up with a sodden patch, but. And you can use your template.
Multiple use.
Absolutely. Sorry, I'm just flicking because I'm trying to get that off. That's a bit of a different little angle to it.
And then you can leave that to dry and then
you can
brush over it.
Yeah, and again, you're going to just brush it off, same as we did with the texture paste. So that's your tree. And then really we just need to cut out this now, and then what I'll do is I just put some little squiggles of glue. And you can either use the flitter glue. We have a fine tip, which you can't see right at this moment. We've got a fine tip applicator, which from Indigo Blue, which has a little metal pin that goes into. But you can use this with the top of your flitter glue.
Right.
And you can just write or...
It's the same size.
Yes, it is. And the thing is, you just need to ensure that that dries properly before...
Yeah.
Sorry. Before... That will obviously take a lot longer to dry off before you can use it because it's thicker than what you would if you were just stamping.
Yes.
All right. So just make sure that... or you can use... like a glitter glue, which is fine.
All right, that's pretty much set enough to be able to brush
yeah,
it off.
Yeah, it is, because it's different to using it with glitter than it is with flake. Okay, so that's that bit. And then we're just going to cut out, we need to cut around this circle, which is where this bit comes into play.
Excellent.
Because
stuff.
You still have very much a circle to see where you're going. Now, because I've gone round the glass, I'm trying to keep straight onto the line because obviously you still need this to fit inside your clock aperture. Mm. But it's a bit forgiving, so yeah, okay. And then that's just going to go inside our clock. And then we're pretty much good to start rebuilding. These are great scissors. They've got like a serrated edge to them.
It.
So, okay, and there we are. So the next bit you can do, just make sure that fits in. Now, obviously, that does because that's going to be tight, but I don't want it. So just put back out for a minute. You just need to ensure, because sometimes when you draw around things, obviously it's outside the edge that you want.
Yeah.
All right, and then, as I say, just to either use glitter glue or something of that nature, or you can use your flitter glue to and some flake. Yeah. And then you're just going to randomly dot some little bits.
So adding in some little snowflakes.
Yeah. At the end of the day, it's all texture and it's all just little bits of detail. That
it just adds a little bit of interest.
It does, yeah. And as I say, this is where you can go underneath your buildings. And
which then makes sense when you've done them.
All right. So nothing special, just a little bit of
extra bling.
Detail going on.
Never have too much bling at Christmas.
No, absolutely. Right, now the only thing I would say is that bit does need to dry before you put, obviously, your hands all over it to stick it inside the clock. And also because we're going to add some of the little glass beads for your shaky bit.
Yeah.
And otherwise, much as it's nice for some of them to stick in areas, you don't want it totally covered. So we're going to dry that off and then we're going to stick it inside the aperture.
Excellent.
All right. Okay, so now we're ready to just make the hole in the centre just a little bit bigger, because obviously we've only got a tiny little hole and we've got to get the clock mechanism through there.
Yeah.
So all I'm going to do is let me poke that a minute just so that I can see where I'm going. And then tiny, I'm trying to get it to the angle so you can see. Tiny little snips so that when you push the mechanism through, okay, and then with your choice of glue. Now, I do suggest you've got one that is quite a grabby glue because you need it to stick very well. The edges. Okay.
I was going to say, does this give you a bit of wiggle room to be able to do
it? It does, but you don't actually, you know, as long as you line up, I kind of go with
the numbers
my 6 and 12 that are there, because that obviously helps. Now, just be a little bit careful when you put it in, because you don't want to stick nail marks everywhere around it. But just ensure the edges are down and ensure the middle's down, because obviously that's where your hands are going to come back through and you don't want big ridges where then your hands won't go round because it's too high up. Okay, so that's that. And then you can see where you've... And either with a pencil or something similar, you can just enlarge that hole. Just so that when you put the mechanism through a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Right, now we're going to put the mechanism back into it first, because we don't want a hole in the middle when we put our glass beads in that they're all going to pull through. So if I flip that over, that's going in there, that's going in there, and that's that. Then you need to go back,
just give it a pop,
and just press down in any areas that
because that will
have lifted, just where you've come through. And I just put those around like that. Okay. Now we can put our glass beads in, which are nothing fancy, just the little...
Just little glass see-through
seed beads. Just... It doesn't really pick up very easily.
Yeah.
But, and then put them...
You've got little gold flecks in there as well.
Yeah, there are some, I don't... but just put them, I say, around the centre. Obviously you need to get your hands and things on, but just try and keep a little bit away from the edges, because you've got to get your glass, your front back onto the clock. Okay, and then we're going to put our hands back together. Now I've just gone over these with a little bit of Snow White, just dotted on there, just to give them a little bit, take that.
That's the Snow White paint.
It is, yeah, yeah. And then on the second hand, I've just coated with some matching glitter that goes with the tree.
Right, so you've just added a little bit of glue on that and then...
Yeah, I've just gone over with the flitter glue. And glittered. Do make sure these are dry before you put them back together because everything gets stuck to them otherwise. And then you just need to put these back.
And these just snap.
They
back
do
in.
Just snap on. And then, like I say, I've just put beads everywhere. But make sure you get the hands in the right order. Imagine most of them don't fit if they don't. If you haven't got them around the right way. And I always just don't try and move the hands round inside. Wait until you've put it all together and set the time on is there the back.
Is there like a click or a, no. I don't know, some of the mechanisms?
Some of them do, but no, this one doesn't seem to. But whatever you do, I think with any of them, just push down around the top of the, don't use the hands to press down. And then that's that. Now using one of your flat brushes, try and just pull those loose beads away from the edge. I mean, it doesn't really matter because you can always move them around slightly anyway. Ensure that you have got a clean front. Now, where you've got your two lugs, if you go in one side and then you just need to maneuver the other in, and that might mean that you have to squidge around a little bit, but it will go. Sorry, I'm moving off of, she says, and obviously check that you haven't got.
There you go.
Okay, and then you just have to sort of like feed
push
it
down
back
till
in.
You get a click.
Yeah. Okay, and then mine isn't the cleanest of cloths, but add your battery to the back and
then we have your shaker style snow globe.
Yes, and obviously I would move the hands then from the back rather than
you've got your
You've got the little wheel on the back, but if you, as I say, if you try and move the hands inside, they pop back off again. So once you've got them into place by pushing them down, just leave them be. And these, of course, will look great in any other colorways, because you can, I mean, your teals, even your red and greens, anything. And of course you can paint over the texture paste.
Oh, right, okay.
So, if you wanted to paint over with the Snow White just to sort of give it a little bit of a sheen, or you can change it totally and do a nice green or something around that.
So, theoretically, you could paint that green, put red berries on.
Yep.
And then you could stick some of the holly.
Yep. And then, of course, we've got our Christmas, Merry Christmas, that we're going to put on the outside.
Okay.
Which I've used our design Merry Christmas stamp.
Which is this one
there
here.
There it is, yes.
Is it by Magique?
Yeah.
So design Merry Christmas.
That's the one. And we're going to stamp that out onto some cardstock.
Okay, I know you've got that one there, but you're actually going to
do it. I have, but I'm going to show you because it's not the wording. I've got Christmas time and that's not how, obviously this is what I've made from this one.
Yeah.
So we're going to stamp this using the same colour as we did for
The snow globe.
For the snow globe, yes, because it'll match in then, and we're going to use a piece of card.
Do you want that piece that we did earlier?
Oh yes, that would be good.
One that we left to dry.
Yes, that'll be fine. Sorry, thank you. Because you only need to stamp and cut, if you cut that bit out. So, and we don't need all the holly, so just stamp and cut the center. And we need two of these because one Christmas we're going to keep. And time needs to come from part of the letters from In Christmas. So we need,
need
a whole word and then parts of the other.
Yeah, the E from Mary and the rest of the letters from Christmas.
So, okay, that's all we need to do for that one. And then, you can just kind of rough cut round. So the Christmas you need to keep. So I'm just going to go straight across there because it's easier than trying to manoeuvre an A4 sheet of card. And, you know, this is in with the style of writing. You don't want, you know, yes, neat, but not...
Doesn't have to just, be perfect.
No, so you just kind of cut around that part. And you can follow whatever bits of contour you want. I think just to give it a little bit of something. Okay, so that's your Christmas. And then we need some letters from this one. Need to be a little bit more careful with the Mary because we need the E. So cut the image out. And we need to keep the E from this one. And then we need the T. And we also need the M, so do be careful cutting round. I mean, the glory of this is the fact that, you know, you can always stamp it again if
you make a colossal mess of it.
So it's not the end of the world, but...
No, but it's a good little tip if you haven't got a full alphabet set that you want to use.
And the thing is, this one's that much smaller than the actual alphabet set. So we need an I. So, yeah, you know, you can always do this as long as you've got the right letters in. In the words, you can keep mine, and then we just need the M. And then using your, you either need a 3D sort of glue gel or a hot glue.
We've got some heavy gel medium.
Yes, you just need something that's going to, you know, grab it really. Let's take that bit off because that looks... Okay, and then that's just good. And then I've inked on this one. I've just inked around the edges. I've just used the same on a little bit of sponge and just gone round the edge, and with the little letters, and just finishes it really rather than a.
Adds a little frame border to it.
So we're going to stick a lot.
Going to use that.
Yes. Just kind of look at where. Whoops! A look at where you're attaching it to, because you obviously need paste for it to attach to.
Yeah.
So if you're going off the edge.
So you need to put enough glue on there. Hold of.
As I say, either hot glue or 3D glue is probably better than this, but. And then these can just go. And I think there's an upside down and an upside down with the eye. Just look at where it is in there. Yeah, only because, well, I've only done it because I... And they haven't got to be straight by any means.
Does anything?
No. Well, yes. Yes, it does. In my straight world, things that are supposed to be straight need to be straight. And if they don't, then they've got to be completely wonky. I can't do a millimetre or so out here and there, unfortunately.
And then you could, if you wanted to, you could just go around the outside or the bottom part, just put a layer of glitter on there as well, couldn't you?
Yeah.
Just to finish it off with that that kind of snow thing.
Yeah, you can. You can use the same thing. And as I say, with the outer edge, you can put some glue, some paint around the outside. And whilst that's wet, you could put a few more of the glass beads on as well, which will give it a little bit more of a shimmer. But no, I mean, you can change these as much as you want to. You know, it's just really giving a few techniques and ideas and
a bit of Christmas decor that can come out year after year.
Absolutely, yes. And lovely gifts for people.
Yes.
Yeah, it's
a keepsake.
It is. Yes. You just have to try and do an Easter one then to swap it with, and a nice for all sorts of occasions with just changing the stamps and the colours. Okay.
Lovely.
Thank you.
Well, that's all we've got time for today. It's been a very, very busy project, hasn't it?
Yes.
And we've got
everything going on.
Yeah, and we've got one still drying.
Yes.
And that's staying here.
Yes, you can have that one.
Yeah, thank you. Okay. So hope you'll join us again real soon for our next Indigo Blue Hour. Thanks for watching.
Bye.
Bye.